bees. We don't all agree about bees, but non-objectively speaking, bees are great. I like bees, and so should you. If you don't, perhaps this 5-minute video will change your mind. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if all the bees died? A small question for you before we begin answering this big question. Are you a subscriber to our channel? If you want to become a questioner like me, then hit that big red subscribe button and make sure you watch all the way through to the end of this video for some recommendations for other videos we think you'll like. Okay, back to the bees. You may have heard people say things like, well, if all the bees die, humanity will die out too. Cue lightning strikes and earthquakes and general pandemonium. While that sentence is pretty far-fetched, we would be pretty screwed without our furry buzzing friends, and here is why. Bees have a very important job. Not only do they provide us with delicious honey and wax, they also pollinate. Pollination is a serious business and allows a huge amount of fruits, nuts, and bean plants to grow. Pollination also allows for the production of cotton. Bees are the world's main pollinator. Bees are fuzzy and perfect for collecting pollen and transferring it from male to female plants as they buzz around looking for nectar. While bees are not the only insect that has the ability to pollinate, they account for around 70% of the world's pollination, so without them, our food and clothing sources would be greatly depleted. If all the bees died, a lack of lovely honey would be the least of our problems. While we would still be able to make wax, there would be no beeswax around. But again, we could live without that. What we probably would struggle to live without is apples, mangoes, almonds, plums, peaches, nectarines, strawberries, apricots, avocados, cherries, lemons, limes, raspberries, cranberries, grapes, tomatoes, onions, almonds, cashew nuts, chestnuts, kidney beans, lima beans, sunflower oil, coffee. Okay, I got slightly bored of naming produce because actually the list is pretty endless, but these are just some of the things that would be at least 70% depleted if all the bees died, which means any of these things that did still manage to grow would be hella expensive. See ya, Starbucks! Also, what will us millennials do with the price of avocado toast soaring much higher than the prices of all these houses we were supposed to be saving for? While I may be making light of the depletion in our food source, it is actually pretty darn serious. The knock-on effect from a 70% decrease in these things is pretty wild too. Some of you may remember mad cow disease. It was a neurodegenerative disease caught by swathes of cattle because they were, to put it simply, eating terrible food often made from other cows' brains. This is not cool. These days, responsible farmers feed their cattle and other livestock things like almonds and other natural produce, which, wait. How are we gonna feed the cows now the bees have died and left us more than semi-nutless? Problems. And if we can't feed the cows and the chickens, what will happen to cheese, milk, eggs, butter, and meat, for those of you that still eat it? More of our food supplies will be gone, which is a problem when the world's population keeps on swelling. Without the bees aiding pollination, there is no nice way to put it, we will starve. Yes, we can still eat wind-pollinated goods like corn and rice, but at the moment, there is not enough to go around as a main food source for all. So we would be starving and maybe a little bit naked, seeing as cotton plants would be pretty barren sans bees. But we would also be poor, which really doesn't sound fun. In the United States, bees are reported to bring in over $15 billion in crop value alone. So who watching this is thinking that the lack of bees sounds like absolutely no fun? I'm raising my hand, you just can't actually see me. You may be concerned to hear that honeybees are on the decline, a really sharp decline. Pesticides are confusing bees, leading to colony collapse disorder, the abandonment of hives, which causes their colony to die off. It's not just pesticides leading to the decline in bees either. Climate change is having a huge effect on them. Reportedly, the honeybee population of the United States is half what it was during the 1950s. So we all know what could happen if all the bees died. However, it doesn't need to end this way. During his presidency, Obama established the Pollinator Health Task Force to help protect bees' environments, knowing that they are crucial to the food chain. You can even help by growing pesticide-free flowers and keeping water in your garden in the summer. Hurrah for bees! Thank you guys for tuning in to this episode of Life's Biggest Questions. If you would like to continue the discussion, then please do so in the comments section down below. Any beekeepers out there, I would love to hear your thoughts as you are the main bee professionals. Make sure you like this video and share it with a friend who needs to learn about bees today. I'm Rebecca Felgate, I'll catch you in the next video, but for now, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning. Are you guys still hungry for answers? Here are two more videos that we think that you will enjoy. Also, click that big question mark to subscribe to our channel.